beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I do the crisscross hairstyle using crochet hair. And the hair that I will be using is the Fashion Idol Express by Sleek. It's their Boho Satin braid in 20 inches and I choose the color 1B. And each pack did cost me €9.98. And I had a total of 3 packs, which was more than enough to cover the whole backside of my head. If you have longer or thicker hair, or your head is a little bit bigger than mine, I would suggest to buy an extra pack just to be safe, but 3 packs was enough for my head. So the first thing I'm going to do is to unbraid these braids and start to detangle my hair. First, I'm going in with my white tooth comb, and afterwards I will start detangle with my Afro pick. You want to start each style with fully detangled hair. By the way, please don't mind my voice. I am a little bit sick while I'm doing this voiceover, but I really wanted to finish this video, so that's why my voice sounds a little weird. And oh my god, please don't mind me playing with this weird ass Afro. But I was kind of feeling myself with this hair. So yeah. The first thing you want to do after detangling your hair is to separate the front part of your hair from the back. The front part is where the actual crisscross design is going to be. So you have to decide for yourself how big or small you want your part to be. I decided to go in from the back of my ear, from left to right, and when I'm completely satisfied with how big my section is, I'm going to take all my hair from the back and put it in a small little bun, because for this crisscross design in the front, you don't need the excess hair from the back. For this hairstyle, I wanted the middle part, so I took my Rattail comb and parted my hair straight down the middle. I'm going to use the Shine and Gem conditioning gel for my scalp, just to make my partings look more neat and sleek. I definitely think that the Shine and Gem conditioning gel is the way to make your crisscross design look very crisp, so yeah. I think that if you don't use it, your parts will look not as neat as when you would use it. So I'll definitely recommend it, but it's not a must to do it. I didn't want to do the smaller crisscross design. I wanted to do them big. So I decided to make 4 big crisscross designs in the front, but you will see it throughout the video. I also added the Shine and Gem on my roots to make my hair look very sleek and shiny. And when I did that, I go in with my edge brush to comb my hair in the way I want it to fall. So when I put on the elastic bands, my hair lays perfectly. A major key for this hairstyle is to start twisting your roots so your hair can look so tight and neat at the same time. This is what I will do before I add my elastic bands. And as you can see right here, my elastic bands are dripped in my hair growth oil. I like to do this just to prevent my hair from breakage. Before I start to make the actual crisscross design, I'm adding some oil to my hair. And I also added some more of the shine and gem on the strands of my hair as well. I'm going to detangle this first with my red tail comb and afterwards with my tangle teaser. This is just to make sure that there are no knots and that it can lay as flat as possible. When my hair has enough of the shine and gem, I'm going to start twisting the front piece all the way to the back, and I start to twist the back section as well with the front piece before I add my elastic band. This is just so your crisscross design can look as neat as possible. So now I will braid the backside of my hair into some cornrows, and I will just take my parting line from the front as a guideline to take this all the way to the back. I will show you how I did this. As you can see, from front to back, I just take the line straight to the back and make this as my partings. I had a total of 8 cornrows on my head. What I will do now is to detangle my hair again and take the front piece with the back, and to make this into one cornrow so all my hair can be braided up into the back. Thank you. This is my growth oil and I will use this to oil my scalp so my hair can be moisturized while it's in this protective style. And I will take the ends of my braids to braid these into two tight little braids so I can tuck them in underneath my cornrows with my crochet needle. But I'll show you this in the next clip. It was kind of hard for me to get this filmed right, but I'll try to explain. I'm going in with my crochet needle underneath my cornrow and I pull my ends of my hair through my cornrow on the other side. And this is what I'm doing until it's tight. So this is what it's looking like. This is the synthetic crochet hair that we are going to use. It was very hard and crunchy when you take it out of the package. You can definitely feel that they put some coating onto the hair, maybe to make it shinier or something, I don't know. But when you run your fingers through it, it will get a little bit softer. You can also add oils if that works for you. So I'm going in with my crochet needle, put it underneath my cornrow, put the hair into the hook, close the hook, open it up, and I take only one side of the hair to pull it through the loop. As you can see right here. Then I'm going in with my hands again to make another knot, just to make sure that the hair won't come out. Once again, I'm going in with my crochet needle underneath my cornrow. I put the hair in the hook, close it, and I put the hair back in the loop to pull only one side of the hair through the loop so you can have one knot, and then I go back in with my hands to make another knot. This is what I will do throughout my whole head until the back is completely covered, and yeah, that's it. This is the end result and I really was pleased with how this hair came out. I also enjoyed making this video, so if you also like this video as I did, please give it a thumbs up, like, comment and subscribe. And if you have any questions, just leave them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. And yeah, I want to thank you guys for watching if you made it to the end. So bye guys.